Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. My name is Francesco D'Alessio and welcome back to another video. Yes, today is another Notion video. Apologies to those guys who are like, stop doing Notion videos, Francesco. I do think I'm going a little bit overboard with them, but it's because I've been getting so many comments saying, please do more Notion videos. One of the top recommendations is, how can I use Notion as a way to replicate Todoist, Trello, Google Calendar, and Evernote as my note taker, my calendar, and my task manager, as well as managing projects. So guys, today's video, I'm dedicating it to that. I've created a few templates inside of Notion that hopefully will give you an explainer into how you could do that, although I don't necessarily recommend it right now. Anyway guys, without further ado, let's jump into the laptop and dive into Notion plus task plus notes plus calendar feature. Hello everyone, so here we are with the workflow that I've set up. What I've tried to do in this setup is actually show you what Todoist would sort of look like inside of Notion, what Trello would look like, what Google Calendar and what Evernote would look like. So I want to start with Notion and tasks. Of course, this is just a demonstration with Todoist versus necessarily it being exact. This is more of a how could you plan with a task manager inside of this. Now, this is something that I definitely saw inside of the likes of David Pierce's setup. He uses a task board in there. So I'll definitely try to snap that or share it with you because I think it looks fantastic. The thing that you can see here is that I have sort of created a mock setup inside of this account. And you can definitely take this as sort of a general guideline if you're looking to do something like this. So as you can see here, what you can do is obviously have, let's just separate this out a sec. Let's show you this top area. Project A, that's just a subtask, a subheader with a divider here. But you can essentially have these checklists of your tasks. Now, as you can see, you've got reminder set up here. So I can just click in and set a reminder on this one, and that's simply, but for example, you press at and you can set it up to next Tuesday at 3 p.m. and then go down to remind at time of event and it will appear then. So as you can see, you can set up reminders per task you've got there, and of course they'll pop up inside of this all update section. As you can see, I've had one come through here. So as you can imagine, it's fairly easy to visualize that, and you can break them out into projects if you wanted to. And of course, that's really for people that have more of a, like a project-based or higher priority things. And if you wanted to in real depth, if you really did want to add more tasks to it, I guess you could use a toggle list function and then start adding some blocks there. So for example, if you had this one here, you can have that as all the subtasks for it. And that's a good way in doing subtasks. A bit of a sort of, you know, love-hate one, because obviously it's a bit of a tricky one to do when you start, but let's say you wanted to have it like that, you could do so and then be able to tick these off here to quite like that. So you can use a toggle function, but in simple, you could use the to-do list function, which is available through options. Now, the secondary way of doing it I wanted to demonstrate is a task board. Now, it's pretty simple. You can use, you essentially open up a Kanban board inside of your, essentially you press this basics block, and then you go down all the way to board inline, and this will appear. So as you can see, what I've demonstrated is a really simple layout. I've got Tuesday the 4th, which is this coming Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday, and maybe you wanted Friday, maybe you wanted the week ahead, and change these ones every single week, or you have a different project that you're working on, whatever it is, you could have the tasks here and of course put them down there. Now, they work in a similar way to projects. So if I clicked into here, you can see that I've added a tab called project and used the multi-select to add project A, and there's an option for project B there too. So that helps to indicate. Now, if you're wondering how you actually see that, you go over to properties and open up project there. So you can see that the tags disappear, but they're a good indicator because that's what comes up inside of Todoist. Now, if you wanted to create subtasks inside there, you can go to edit page content and you could add a few subtasks like bullets and start going straight away at it. Or if you want to assign it to someone else, you could quickly do that there. So, and of course, add comments in the same fashion.
But as you can imagine, it's entirely up to you into how to you use it in practice. But this whole board experience could easily be manipulated by adding columns. So the task board is definitely accessible. So as you can imagine, inside of the workflow, you can use something like Trello. You can use a project management style setup. So essentially, if you want to manage by Kanban board like we did there, you can actually create a page from scratch that has a Kanban board setup. And of course, inside of Notion, you have multiple views, so you can add to it and change it into a table or calendar if you wanted. I guess very similar to the likes of the power-ups inside of Trello. Now, if, for example, I wanted to use a traditional Kanban layout, I have to-do, doing, done, many variations of it, of course, and I am grouping using my tags. So, for example, if I wanted to move one across, okay, I'm doing task A now, I've completed task D, then you can continually add to that. And of course, in the same fashion that you would with your Trello account, you can add properties, add fields essentially, assign it to people, add due dates, add files, add checkboxes, URLs. And I'm not sure whether you can add an image to it, which helps to indicate the sort of preview to it. That's something I'm not actually sure of. You won't be able to do that in cover because it won't bleed out on the page like that. But again, that's a whole board page and something that you can use. You can add lots of context to it. And if you're working in teams, you can use it for discussion and mention people too, which is very helpful. So if I wanted to tag Alice in there and send her a notification about this, that's easily done and easily created. So it's very similar to creating an experience inside of Asana. For example, if you wanted to have multiple boards, you could make this one a landing page and then be able to add different boards to it as pages. Now, just a reminder of how you create a page as a board in full. So you scroll and there should be one saying board full page. That's how you create a Kanban on its own page. Now, that's very easy. And that's the Trello side of stuff. If you wanted to replicate Google Calendar, it's going to be a little bit trickier. This is what I've demonstrated so far. So this is a calendar page, again, very similar to the boards we just set up there. You can see here that this is the date we're on because the red indicates over the top of it. If you want to add an item, all you have to do is press add, and you can see the icon appear there. And actually, it's creating an event automatically. So I'm just going to delete this one in the example. So you can see here that I've added Barcelona here. So I've added an icon, I've added Barcelona, I've added the tags on whether it's like a family event or a social event, etc. And I've also added the start and end dates, and you can include end times too. So if you wanted to add event details, you could down here in the same fashion. And you can add specific times, which is quite cool. You can even set reminders too. So for example, you can hit this one, reminders, and include time as well, which you add up here. So as you can imagine, the calendar is scrollable, so you can just go endlessly. Although there is a way to sort stuff into different sortings of names and dates. So for example, if you wanted dates ascending, and obviously that would happen, but if you wanted dates descending, you can add that there. So that's a way to sort it. Not very necessarily if you wanted to create a prioritization there. You can search it as well. So for example, if I'm like badminton, there you go. You can see all of the upcoming badmintons or like spaghetti Western weekend is coming up there. So that's quite easy. You can filter again using the what's assigned to me, or you can maybe have a shared calendar if you were in a team. And you can even see the completed tasks of that. And if I wanted to, I've added properties on and off, so I can see quickly, okay, I've got a work event, a social event, and a family event in the next month. So I can see that at a glance, and I can get rid of the dates if I wanted to, if that's something that was blocking my experience. Now, if I wanted to, I can calendar by date, which is pretty default. And if I wanted to add new items, I could do that there. So I can see the next month just by viewing that sort of there, and I can hit today anytime. So you can use the calendar. It does lack viewing options at the moment, I'd say. Something that I haven't actually been able to check out yet in full is actually how to get it into week view, but I can imagine they'll be looking to do that. When I think they add Google Calendar integration, that's when it'll explode, and it will lack integrations at the moment. But again, it's possible to do Google Calendar inside of Notion. So final, and the most requested is Evernote. You can actually create an Evernote-like experience inside of Notion. So you can see here, I've created notebook A, notebook B, notebook C, notebook D, and I've used demos here. So let's just go into the demo one. Very similar, you can create whatever template you like, whatever sort of experience you like, notebook A. Again, very demonstration-like. You can use demo notes or blog posts in there, whatever it is that you want. They work essentially as notes. And this is another one. You could have a Kanban board that has all notes here or a certain column that indicates stuff. And then you click demo note A and you use this as your note board. And you can add all of the details of the note up here. So that's all of the information, what the last time it was actually edited, etc. There's loads that you can do with it. So again, it's really customizable. If you wanted to really go into it, you could actually replicate Evernote spaces here if you wanted to, using some of the automation functions. So guys, that was pretty much the experience. You can use this for replicating most of the other applications. As you can imagine, it's not a foolproof method. It's gonna take a bit of time to set up. These are a few demo ones, but hopefully gave you a good idea of what this account would look like if you actually set everything up inside of here. But again, I don't recommend it necessarily for all of that just yet. Guys, let me know in the comments how you use Notion currently. I'd love to hear. Again, I'll try to really focus on other features too, apart from Notion, but so many guys are enjoying this because it's such a new resource. If you are brand new to Notion, you've got all the way through that and you're like, how the hecky-decky do I do that? You can check out the Notion guidebook, which will take you through the application from start to finish and maybe get you to a point, like for example, my setup right now, that maybe get you to that point. Mainly I've had a whole year and a bit on Notion, so it's taken me a good amount of time to get there. Anyway, guys, huge thanks for stopping by today. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.